No reason was given in the gospel why the disciples prevented the children from coming to Jesus. Perhaps the disciples saw that the Lord is tired or was tired, that they wanted the Lord to have some rest. But here in the gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, it shows that people for the Lord, especially children, are more important than personal rests. Marahil pagod ang Panginoon, pero para sa Panginoon, ang mga tao ay mas importante kaysa sa kanyang pagpapahinga. That is why the Lord allowed the children to come to Him. And according to this gospel, He placed His hands on them, blessed them. Siguro kung kultura na ng mga Hudyo nung araw, ang pagmamano, baka hinayaan ni Jesus na magmano ang mga bata sa kanya. So, there are two things that I would like to point out in this gospel. Number one, as our reflection, do we prevent people to come to Jesus? By our words, by our attitude, by our action. Do we become the hindrance, the obstacle for people to come nearer to the Lord? Tayo bang nagiging dahilan, nagiging sagabal para ang mga tao ay masigit na makilala ang Panginoon? Kayong mga altar servers, no? I welcome you because this morning you will have your ongoing formation. Kayo'y mga taong simbahan. Tayo ay mga taong simbahan. Meron na ba kayong naakay? Nakaibigan? Para mag-serve sa Panginoon? O baka naman kumisan nagiging exclusive ang grupo nyo? That can happen, no? That we in the church sometimes form an exclusive club to the point that others who are outside the exclusive club are not allowed to come in. Meron tayong dito sa, lalo na sa Metro Manila, meron tayong tinatawag na gated subdivisions. For their protection, you cannot just enter into the subdivision. You need the sticker. You have to show your ID, license. But sometimes, that is what prevents people from entering into the place. That is the first thing that we should ask ourselves. Are we like the disciples preventing people to come near to the Lord? The other reflection is this. Jesus blessed the children. Are we also source of blessing to others? By our words, by our attitude, by our action. Tayo ba ay nagiging instrumento ng pagpapala? Tayo ba ay nagiging instrumento ng inspirasyon? Gumagaang ba ang pakiramdam ng ating kaibigan, kasama sa paglilingkod dahil sa ating mga magandang sinabi? We should be blessings to people. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, as we continue in this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask for two graces from the Lord and from the Blessed Mother. First, that we may not be the cause of scandal to other people, that they turn away from God, from the Church. And secondly, let us pray that we may always be a source of blessing and inspiration to others, especially to those who are not still yet part of the Christian community. Kasi kuminsan, nahahati tayo eh. Taong simbahan. Tayo, mga taong simbahan. Yung iba, hindi taong simbahan. Sana dumating ang araw na lahat ay maging taong simbahan. Amen.